President Rodrigo Duterte, in his Monday night address, slammed social media giant Facebook for taking down accounts and pages linked to the advocacies of the Philippine military and police. He says Facebook is pointless if it fails to help the government.
You know, Facebook insurgency is about overturning government. What would be the point, I said before, in my eyes, what would be the point of allowing you to continue if you cannot help us?
The page Hands Off Our Children was taken down for alleged coordinated inauthentic behavior. Supported by the AFP, the page is owned by a group of parents campaigning against the New People's Army's youth recruitment. The president now wants to talk it out with Facebook to discuss its policies.
You cannot lay down a policy for my government. I allow you to operate here. You cannot bar or prevent me from espousing the objectives of government.
Some Facebook users are worried that Duterte's words might mean banning Facebook in the country.
Kapag nawala po yung Facebook, is hindi ko na mai-share by online yung Word of God, by sa mga Bible, sa mga kinakailangan. Tsaka yung business ko po is mahinto.
Kasi doon lang po tayo kumbaga makakapag-communicate, lalo-lalo na sa mga kamag-anak nating malalayo. Kumbaga, so doon na lang natin sila makakapiling through sa Facebook.
But the palace clarifies, no, Facebook will not be banned, nor will freedom of expression be curtailed. Spokesperson Harry Roque said Duterte only wants to discuss possible policy changes on Facebook.
Yung founder ng Facebook mismo, talagang sinasabi niya na marami talagang malawakang reforma ang kinakailangan nilang gawin. No? Sinabi nga niya minsan, baka nga kinakailangan magkaroon ng kahit papanong regulasyon sa Facebook. No? At kinakailangan ma-identify talaga nila kung sino talaga yung mga actors sa Facebook. So ito po ay usapin na nangyayari sa buong daigdig.
Roque, for one, questioned Facebook's choice of fact-checkers.
Bakit kapag pabor sa gobyerno, tinatanggal? Kapag pabor sa oposisyon, hindi tinatanggal, no? Bakit ang fact-checkers laban sa gobyerno? Sino pa dito sa bayan na ito ang magdududa na ang Rappler at ang Verifiles ay talaga namang kontra sa administrasyon ni Presidente Duterte?
The AFP supports the call to continue talks with Facebook. They are also requesting for the list of purged accounts allegedly linked to the military,
so that we will be aided by it in our validation and in our investigation if and imposition of penalties when warranted, specifically if the posts violated our existing AFP social media policy and use.
Social media expert Carlo Ople explained that Facebook, being a private company, is governed by its own policies. But a third-party team can be summoned for evaluation and policy improvement, just as they did in the past.
I think they recruited several high-profile former journalists to government officials to take a look at their policies and their content. And if I'm not mistaken, there's like even a counter, like a third-party board that's going to also investigate and always be noisy every time Facebook does something wrong. So, ang dami nang tumitingin sa kanila.
Meanwhile, cybercrime law expert attorney J.J. Dicini said the government can in fact regulate Facebook in the Philippines.
I think ang you can regulate, kasi pwede yan, spectrum yan, pwedeng you can regulate, pwedeng ano rin, ang gagawin mo, instead na mag-regulate ka, mag-accountability na lang, have a local presence para meron kaming mapupuntahan.
This, he says, will help establish accountability, especially when cybercrime is committed.